biology.
So welcome to this class, whereby in this class we are going to discuss about tissues. In the previous class we discussed about the cell, and we saw on different types of cells in the organisms that we have. Now in this class let's discuss about tissue, whereby let's define what is a tissue. So a tissue is a group of similar cells working together to perform a specific function. Let's begin with the animal tissues, then we complete with the plant tissues. So in the animal tissue, the first tissue we have is the connective tissue, which mainly consists of a network of strong fibers and specialized cells. What's the function of the connective tissue? So they provide support and bind other tissues together that you are going to look at. So the next tissue we have the nerve tissue, which mainly consists of the nerve cells. So they receive and transmit impulse. So that's the function of the nerve tissue. So the next tissue we have is the epithelial tissue, which mainly consists of very thin cells. And what's the function of the epithelial tissue? So these ones protect the inner tissues from damage or from any other agent of damage, that is. So the next tissue we have is the skeletal tissue, which mainly consists of bones and cartilages, protecting the soft tissues of the body. So the next one we have the blood tissue, which mainly comprises of the red blood cell, which transports dissolved gases. We have the white blood cells, whereby the function of the white cells is to fight harmful microorganisms and the platelets responsible for blood clotting process. So let's look at the plant tissues that we have. Let's begin with the epidermal tissue. So epidermal tissue, from the word epidermis, so this tissue is a thin layer of cells which mainly cover the outer surface of the plant. So the function is that it protects the inner tissues from infections and mechanical damage. So the next tissue in plants we have the palisade tissue. So in the palisade mesophyll, we have these cells which are richly impregnated with chloroplast. What's the function of chloroplast? So the function of chloroplast is that they serve as an agent for photosynthesis, and that's the function of the palisade tissue. So the next tissue we have the conducting tissue, which mainly comprises of the xylem vessels and the phloem vessel. The function of the xylem vessels is to transport water and mineral salts through the plant, while the function of the phloem is for the translocation of dissolved food substances within the plant. So now let's look at an organ after we have done with the tissue. So what is an organ? These are many tissues which have come together to perform a specific function. That is the organ. So let's look at the organs in the animals. We have the liver, we have the heart, we have the skin, we also have the lungs for gases exchange, we have the stomach for digestion of substances, we have kidneys, then we have the eyes, and then finally we have the tongue for tasting. So let's look at the different organs in the plant. So the first organ in the plant, we have the stem, we also have the leaves, and then we have the roots, and finally we have the flowers for reproduction. So finally, let's look at the organ system. So the organ system, we say that this is a group of different organs that have come together to perform a specific function. So the different types of organ system that we have the respiratory system, we have the digestive system, we have the excretory system, we have the circulatory system, and the nervous system for impulse transmission and response. So just to have a recap of cell specialization, we defined a cell as the basic unit of living organism. So we went to tissues and we say that in tissues, these are many cells that have come together to perform a specific function. So after the tissues, we went ahead and defined the organ and say these are different tissues that have been specialized and come together to perform a specific function. So after the organ, we define the organ system and say that these are many organs that have come together to perform a specific function. Now let's meet on the next class as we now embark on cell physiology.
Biology.